Continuing where we left off on the previous page, I said continuous functions are functions you can draw without lifting your pencil. Well, one thing we know, a type of function that we analyzed deeply in college algebra was polynomial functions. And every polynomial function, if it's odd, it either starts high and ends low, or starts low and ends high. And then that's if it's odd. If it's even, it starts high, ends high, starts low, ends low. But you could draw the entire picture of a polynomial function without lifting your pencil once. So that means it's continuous everywhere. So all polynomial functions are continuous everywhere. And so since we write our answers in interval notation, we would write our intervals of continuity for all polynomial functions as negative infinity, infinity. And then on the previous page, I also mentioned rational functions. I talked about 1 over x. We noticed that x equals 0 was where it was not continuous because it was a vertical asymptote. Well, if you remember college algebra, where do those vertical asymptotes come from? They come when the function's undefined, and the function's undefined for a rational function. Remember, rational functions are fractions. So fractions are undefined when the bottom equals 0. So a rational function is going to be continuous everywhere except for when the bottom equals 0. So set the bottom equal to 0, the denominator. Set the bottom equal to 0 and solve. And then exclude those numbers. So anytime it's a polynomial, we know the answer is negative infinity to infinity. Anytime it's a rational function, we're just going to set the bottom equal to 0 and solve, and it's going to be every number except those numbers. So let's look at this right here. Remember, every work you have to show problem on the test and on your lecture notes. You have to show work, no credit. So this first one says determine the continuity of each of the following functions. Of course, we're writing our answers in interval notation. So this first function is x squared plus x plus 1. Well, here's my work. That's a polynomial, so I'm just going to write poly. And every single polynomial we know is continuous on the interval, negative infinity to infinity. B is x cubed plus x, which is also a polynomial function. So again, I have to show work. I'm just going to indicate to the reader that I know that this is a polynomial function. So the answer is negative infinity to infinity. We could draw it without lifting up our pencils. Same thing with x to the fourth. Again, this is a simple example of a polynomial function. So the answer would be negative infinity to infinity. Remind yourself that polynomial functions are functions that look like x cubed plus x squared minus 2x plus 1. They have x's raised to whole positive numbers. So it's not things like the square root of x. It's not things like x to the 3/2 or x to the negative 2 or 1 over x. It is just the nice ones, the x to the 5th plus 2x cubed minus 3x, etc. Okay? So those are all the polynomial functions. The answer every time is going to be negative infinity to infinity. Let's move on to those rational functions. Rational functions again mean it's a fraction, and what we do with a rational function, as we discussed earlier, is you want to set the bottom equal to 0. Really, you're saying the bottom can't equal 0 if you want to be strict about it. So we're saying x minus 1 cannot equal 0. Add 1 to both sides and you would have x cannot equal 1. So if you're thinking about a real number line, here's the number 1. I know I have to exclude that number 1, but I can include every single thing else. So as we go from left to right, what x values are we talking about? Well, it goes all the way to the left, which would be negative infinity to 1. I'm going to put my parentheses there because intervals of continuity are always using parentheses for the vast, vast majority of them. And then I pick back up. You can use the union. You don't have to. Pick back up at 1 and go all the way to the right, which would be infinity. So that's how in interval notation we would exclude the number 1, as we saw in the review packets. Okay, let's look at f of x equals x squared minus 4 over x minus 2. Some of you might have noticed that the top is a difference of squares, so this is x plus 2 times x minus 2 all over x minus 2. And then you cross out your x minus 2s because they simplify. So this turns into x plus 2. X plus 2 is a polynomial function. Polynomial functions are continuous on the intervals negative infinity to infinity, right? So this function is continuous on negative infinity to infinity. And the answer is no. That is absolutely wrong. Everything I just did is completely, utterly wrong. Never, ever, ever with rational functions simplify first. Do not simplify first. I cannot express that enough. Do not Do not simplify. Anytime you're dealing with a rational function for intervals of continuity, you want to straight up set the bottom equal to 0. So let's do this. X minus 2 cannot equal 0. Add 2 to both sides, and this is saying x cannot equal 2. We actually do have restrictions. The other answer we got was negative infinity to infinity when we simplified. But notice, if we put in the number 2, we would have 0 over 0, which is our indeterminate form, which means our function is undefined at x equals 2. Well, that was the first criteria of being continuous. The function had to be defined. So we're going to say everywhere but the number 2. Let's think about that real number line. Here's the number 2, and it can be everything else. We go to as far as we can to the left would be negative infinity to 2 with parentheses. Use the union symbol if you want. Pick back up at 2 and go all the way to infinity. Okay, let's move on to the next one. How about 1 over x squared plus 2? So what we're saying is this bottom cannot equal 0. So we'd have x squared plus 2 cannot equal 0. Subtract 2 from both sides and I'd have x cannot equal negative 2. And then the idea is we would take the square root of both sides, remembering plus or minus, but plus or minus square root of negative 2 does not exist. You can't take the square root of a negative number. So what the heck does that tell me? This tells me this never equals 0. So if that never equals 0, then we have no restrictions. So there's no restrictions. And if there's no restrictions, that means it can be any number, and any number is written as negative infinity to infinity. So if you ever have an issue or a point in time when you're trying to take a square root of a negative number, you know it doesn't exist. And remember, we were trying to say, when is this bottom equal to 0? Well, that doesn't exist. So it never equals 0, so it's never undefined, so there's no restrictions. Okay? Answer would still be negative infinity to infinity. Let's read this next part together. It says, if a function is not continuous at a point, we call it discontinuous. I mentioned that on the previous page. There are two types of discontinuity, removable and non-removable discontinuity. Removable discontinuity is when f can be made continuous by redefining the graph at a single point. Non-removable discontinuity is when f cannot be made continuous by defining it at a point. Look at the following two examples. So if I look at this graph, this first graph right here is of x squared minus 1 over x minus 1. It's a nice line, except it has an open circle at the point 1, 2. If you notice, if we came in here and we defined it at the point 1, 2 and closed that circle, if we were able to make a single point and now, voila, that function's continuous, then that is called a removable discontinuity. Versus look at the second graph, which is 1 over x. 1 over x has a vertical asymptote at x equals 0. There is no single point that we could put a point when x equals 0 that would connect those two sides of the graph, making it continuous. Okay? So if we can't put a point there, then we cannot make it, cannot put a point there to make it continuous, then that is called a non-removable discontinuity. It says the first graph has a single point discontinuity at x equals 1. This is a removable discontinuity. The second graph is discontinuous at x equals 0, but cannot be made continuous by simply adding or moving a single point. So that would make it a non-removable discontinuity.